President Duterte is set to fire all Bureau of Corrections officials and personnel involved in corruption in the implementation of the controversial Good Conduct Time Allowance or GCTA law. This amid allegations that GCTA credits are being sold by corrupt officials. Duterte says officials of the Bureau could not be faulted for their supposed wrongful implementation of the GCTA law, as he notes that the controversial measure has provisions that still need clarification.
When the Secretary of Justice himself, si Guevara, said that we will ask for a clarificatory question or for the Supreme Court to explain, that law becomes in doubt, unquestionable. Then you cannot convict a person for the rule that he must be proved to be guilty beyond reasonable doubt.
The Joint Review Committee of the Justice and Interior Departments has already finished the draft of the revised implementing rules and regulations of the GCTA law, which has been submitted by Justice Secretary Menardo Guevara and Interior Secretary Eduardo Año. Government is tweaking the IRR amid claims it was being used by corrupt prison officials to grant early release to inmates in exchange for money. But speaking to ANC, Justice Undersecretary Mark Perete says there are still loopholes that can only be addressed by lawmakers.
There are certain areas in the law which are ambiguous for us and which cannot be cured by the implementing rules and regulations. And these are matters which will be brought up by the department to the Senate as well as the House of Representatives as they amend the law. We have to understand that there are limitations to what can be done considering the state of law based on 10575 as well as 10592. That's why we're also looking at, in long haul, we're also looking at amending the law itself, not only the implementing rules and regulations.
Perete also says the Justice Department is monitoring the Senate probe on the allegations of corruption against Bucor officials. They are also awaiting the results of the probe of the National Bureau of Investigation to determine their possible criminal, administrative, or civil liabilities. The Justice Secretary, meanwhile, says there's a need to review Republic Act 10575, the law which strengthened the Bucor and diminished the control of the Department of Justice over it. Guevara says under the law, the DOJ can only exercise supervision over the Bucor instead of control, which was then used to justify the Bureau's release of high-profile inmates without informing him and asking for his approval. The Senate also discussing the complete overhaul of the state penitentiary.
Nag-usapan na kami na paglabas ng committee report, magbabalangkas na talaga ng legislation talagang para i-reforma, i-overhaul yung ating penitentiary. Sabay-sabay, hindi po pwede nga sabi ko yung band-aid solution na tapal-tapal dahil nanabulgan na GCTA. GCTA lang titingnan natin. Paano yung ibang mga anomalya pa doon?
A week before the end of the President's September 19 deadline, only 353 or 18% of the over 1,900 heinous crime convicts released under the GCTA law have surrendered to authorities.
Umabot na yata ng 30 ang mga nasuspende ng mga opisyalis ng Bureau of Corrections. So naintindihan naman natin na talagang sa ngayon ay hindi pa nila maasikaso, maari yung pagbibigay sa atin ng mga detalye.
The Philippine National Police warns convicts who fail to present themselves by September 19 can be arrested even without a warrant. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.